We can say, call a child now black. And he's proud of it. But when I was a child, if you called me black, you know, I was insulted.
I'm a young black man, doing all that I can.
White man 50 years ago told my granddaddy that when my daddy got free, things would be better. When he got grown, somebody told my daddy that when I got grown, things would be better. Now I'm grown. Now I have the white boy today telling me that when my children get grown, things will be better. So they'll see that this is just an old trick.
You and I live in a country which is supposed to be the citadel of education, freedom, justice, democracy, and all of those other pretty sounding words.
I'm mad as hell. I woke up wanting to see the world burn down yesterday because I'm tired of seeing black men die.
Put your hands.
Bitch, you're not a human.
What's fucking with me, boy? You hear me? Get your ID now.
By the time you were 30,
why you being so hostile?
And by that time you've begun to see it happening in your daughter or your son, nothing you have done, and as far as you can tell, nothing you can do will save your son or your daughter from meeting the same disaster and possibly coming to the same end.
I'm hurt! You don't need to hide! I'm hurt!
We are in a world of pain right now.
African-American man threatening my life.
There are no words.
Racist people at the best.
To describe the depth of pain.
I'm detaining you to investigate.
That I experience.
Freaking picking up trash on my property.
What is society? Society is a contract. It's a contract that we sign as human beings amongst each other. As with most contracts, the contract is only as strong as the people who are abiding by it. Black American people watch time and time again the contract that they have signed with society is not being honored by the society that has forced them to sign it with them.
I was born by the river in a little
when you watch Ahmaud Arbery being shot and you hear that those men have been released, what part of the contract is that in society? When you see George Floyd on the ground and you see a man losing his life at the hands of someone who's supposed to enforce the law,
he is human, bro.
What part of the contract is that?
Imagine the cries from a six-year-old girl that just found out her daddy's been murdered for the world to see.
Look at him.
He's not responsive right now, bro.
I watched a white officer assassinate a black man, and I know that tore your heart out.
In this case, the police officer was dealing with a criminal who was resisting arrest.
If he had not had asthma and a heart condition and was so obese, most definitely he would not have died from this.
You killed my grandbaby. She was only 7 years old.
Seems the escalation of these incidents may be a byproduct of a system that's applied unequally and with prejudice.
You told him to get his ID, sir, and his driver's license. Oh my God, please don't tell me he's dead.
Sir, what's going on?
Gunshots in the store.
She was in her own place. The police shot and killed her. That's murder.
Police said McBride was killed looking for help after a car crash.
Wow.
Get out of the car!
Really, for a failure to signal. You're doing all of this for
get
a failure
get over there!
The world is harsh, and I just don't got no beautiful stories. And once my life is gone, it's gone. Can't nobody give it back to me. They can't do nothing but come to my funeral and talk pretty about how black people suffer.
That looks like a bad dude, too.
That big bad dude, his life mattered.
Right there was my grandson, Dan.
This guy looks like he's up to no good or he's on drugs or something.
If you white folks want to be treated the way blacks are in this society, stand. Nobody's standing here. That says very plainly that you know what's happening. You know you don't want it for you. I want to know why you're so willing to accept it or to allow it to happen for others.
You're not with us, you're against us. And it's no more pacifying, no more straddling the fence.
I'm not standing down. I'm black and I'm brown and I'm strong.
Stand down.
That's what we are strong. No justice.
No peace.
I think we've got to see that a riot is the language of the unheard.
I thank God that we have people in the streets. Can you imagine this kind of lynching taking place and people are indifferent? People don't care?
I had to come here and let my voice be heard.
Y'all coming with a better way? Because we ain't doing it!
Oh my God.
And I have a 5-year-old son, and it ain't happening!
When you talk about the masses of black people, the precious poor, brown, red, yellow, whatever color, they feel so thoroughly powerless, helpless, hopeless, then you get rebellion.
Children, God damn it.
I wish that things could be better for the Negro people.
If you are a black person, walk out on the street every day seeing white policemen surrounding you. I was constantly stopped. And then you ask me whether I approve of violence. I mean, that just doesn't make any sense at all.
True evil is seeing something that's bad and having the power to change it, but do nothing about it at all. I'm going to change it. Like, I'm going to tell people about this. Obviously, I'm just one person. I can't change the world, but I can change a couple of people that I know.
If this is what's going on in our country, it's your responsibility and it's my responsibility to put a stop to it. It's not the victim's responsibility to put a stop to it.
How does a 16-year-old black male in America get respect? How do you learn to survive and adapt in a hostile environment? That's what black people have done all this time. And sometimes we heal crooked.
Our correspondent, Omar Jimenez, being arrested.
The only way to make anything better is to fix a broken system. Cops need to be held accountable. Jail, life. If you were on hand and you didn't stop that senseless murder from happening, you get time too.
We don't need an officer that makes a mistake once, twice, three times, and finally he kills a boy on national TV, and the next thing you know, the country is burning down.
We don't need anybody to tell us to stand up anymore. Not only are we going to stand up, we're going to right the wrongs of our people in this generation.
Time for something to stand for anything.
The next thing is making sure you exercise your political bully power and going to local elections and beating up the politicians that you don't like. You got a prosecutor sent your partner to jail and you know it was bullshit. Put a new prosecutor in there. Now's your election to do it.
We could vote for mayors, we could vote for judges, and we could also vote for district attorneys. These people that are in power, they have power where you live at.
It's up to you to couple every protest with organizing and mobilizing and voting.
I love and respect you all. We must plot. We must plan, we must strategize, organize, and mobilize.
I can keep you safe. It's okay,
I got it, okay.
Because I don't want you to get shielded.
Okay, yes.
That changed the world.
That changed the world.